Hello students, welcome to my class. Today we will study the rest of the part of hydrogen. In the previous video of hydrogen, I had taught you its position in the periodic table, all the chemical reactions that produce hydrogen, laboratory preparation of hydrogen, and removing the impurities and all. In this video, I will be discussing the industrial method of preparation, commercial method of preparation of hydrogen, physical properties, chemical properties of hydrogen, uses of the hydrogen with the resin, and I will also explain in detail the redox reaction, that is oxidation and reduction reaction. I'm sure you will understand this part of the video also like the previous one. So please watch the video and read the chapter, practice the chemical equations, and then solve the exercise. I am sure you will understand and will be able to answer the questions also. In case you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will clear it. I will also discuss the types of questions that you may get in the exam, as I always do in all my videos. So please like, share, and subscribe my channel. And let's begin. So to start with, the industrial method of preparing hydrogen, the first method is Bosch process. In Bosch process, we will be using coke, hot carbon, C plus water. It's actually steam because the temperature is 1000 degrees Celsius to get water gas. Water gas will be written in this method within the bracket. If you do not put the bracket and write only CO plus H2, it is wrong. Minus heat, that means this reaction is endothermic reaction. The second equation for the Bosch process is water gas with again water, which is steam because now the temperature is 450 degrees Celsius, with catalyst ferric oxide will give you carbon dioxide, hydrogen plus heat, and this is exothermic. So the first equation and the first reaction is endothermic. The second reaction is exothermic. Now, when we get hydrogen here, it is quite obvious that we get gaseous carbon dioxide also mixed with hydrogen, and certain amount of carbon monoxide gas also here. So these are now taken as to be impurities which has to be removed. CO2, as we did in the previous video, while removing in the laboratory preparation of hydrogen, KOH is used. You have done this equation, will give you potassium carbonate and water. Carbon monoxide, and if there is a little bit of steam also, can be removed by ammonical cupric chloride and cuprous chloride, and it will absorb both of them. And it is removed. Now you get pure hydrogen by Bosch process. That is one more commercial way of preparing also, that is electrolysis of water. But water, as you all know, will not allow electricity to pass through if it is pure. So in that case, we acidulate it, and acidulating a water is always done by a sulfuric acid. And when electricity is passed through it, the water first dissociates and then it is released as hydrogen and oxygen at the cathode and anode respectively. This gas, which is obtained at the cathode, is pure, so you will not be needing to purify hydrogen in this case. We come to the physical properties. So we all know it is colorless. It is odorless, it is tasteless, it is non-toxic, that means it will not turn any color of the litmus paper. It will not color blue into red, neither red into blue, so it is non-toxic. It is the lightest gas, highly soluble, slightly soluble in water, that means very sparingly soluble in water. liquefies at minus 240 degrees Celsius and 20 atmosphere. That means it can be converted from gaseous state to liquid state. It is readily absorbed by palladium or platinum or nickel, which is otherwise known as occlusion. Important. There are definitions given in your text, so please see that you learn them properly. We now come to the chemical properties, that it is very reactive. It is combustible but does not support combustion. So the reaction, when we say very reactive, it will react with metals, non-metals, organic compounds, because oxygen or hydrogen is found in the combined state. We have discussed this earlier. So to see how it reacts with the metals to produce metal hydrides, with sodium, it will give sodium hydride. With calcium, it will give calcium hydride. And both of them with water will form an alkali, that is hydroxide. And again, hydrogen is released. So this is first type of chemical reaction. We come to the other types of chemical reactions. And these are as this. Reaction of hydrogen with non-metals. It is very reactive, we say. So with oxygen, water. But this reaction, you know, hydrogen will burn with a blue flame, giving you a pop sound. We have done this in the confirmatory test of hydrogen in the practical chemistry. So it's a repetition. It will also react with chlorine, giving you HCl. But this reaction again is slow when it is diffuse sunlight, hardly reacts when in darkness, but it is explosive in direct sunlight. About this also we had discussed, and you all know since you have studied about it last year. With nitrogen, it will give ammonia, and this process is known as Heber's process. It's a reversible reaction. It is exothermic. This reaction is possible in the presence of the catalyst iron and the promoter molybdenum, where the temperature required is 450 to 500 degrees Celsius and 200 to 900 atmosphere pressure. So you need all the conditions along with the equation. If the question is asked, give the chemical equation for Heber process, or give the chemical equation to prepare ammonia from hydrogen, you need to write everything, otherwise you don't get a mark. This is really important because the same thing is there in standard 10 as well, and we demand the same thing from them also. With sulfur, it will give you H2S. Next type of reactions, with metallic oxides. Why? Because hydrogen is a very strong reducing agent, and it will react with some of the metallic oxides to reduce it to metal, converting metal oxide to metal and water. But there are certain metal oxides which will definitely not be reduced with hydrogen, and they are sodium oxide, potassium oxide, calcium oxide, magnesium oxide, and aluminium oxide. Those five will not be able to be reduced by hydrogen. So with copper oxide, we see copper plus water. With lead oxide, lead plus water. With ferric oxide, iron plus water. And the color changes are also shown to you. Like copper oxide, which was black, will give you copper, which is a reddish brown metal. Lead oxide, litharge, PbO, plumbus oxide is yellow in color, giving you lead metal, which is silvery gray. Ferric oxide is brown in color to give you iron, which is again gray in color. So observation question, what do you observe when hydrogen is passed through copper oxide? I have written the answer for you. Give a chemical equation to show that hydrogen is a strong reducing agent. I have given you the answer here. I have just now spoken about three answers in three different types of questions. Name the metallic oxides that can be reduced by hydrogen, and write any three of them. Give a chemical equation to show that hydrogen is a strong reducing agent, any one of them. And what do you observe when any one of them is asked? The answer is written here. So I have actually written the answer for you, and I have told the questions just now, and I'm sure you are going to get one of them. Next, hydrogenation. As I said just now, we did occlusion. They can be absorbed. So they react with organic compounds in the presence of nickel, palladium or platinum also, but nickel, yes, is used very commonly. That is, ethylene with hydrogen will give you ethane, or acetylene with hydrogen will give you ethane in the presence of nickel. So you are going to write nickel here, you are going to write nickel here, otherwise this equation is not correct. Just now I told about Haber's process also. You have to write the conditions. The same I show you in hydrogenation. You have to write the catalyst used, otherwise it is going to be wrong. So the oxides of active metals like potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium do not get reduced by hydrogen. I spoke about it just now. So in naming questions, a question can be twisted. If sodium oxide plus hydrogen is given, you will have to write no reaction. The next. Now we come to the uses of hydrogen. And as I said, I will be giving the reason also. It is used as a fuel. Why? Because it is high heat combustion. Because when it is burnt, huge amount of heat is released. Highly exothermic because of its high heat of combustion. Second, in oxyhydrogen torch. Why? To produce temperature of some 2500 degrees Celsius, and with oxygen and hydrogen, this much of temperature released is used for cutting and welding of metals, because metal cutting needs a lot of temperature and oxyhydrogen torch is used for that. There is atomic hydrogen torch also, which creates 2800 degrees Celsius for welding alloys. This was metals, this is alloys. Next, in self-lightening gas jets and automatic lighters, because it is always ready to give you heat. In Haber process, we did it just now, to produce ammonia. For hydrogenation of vegetable oil, this also we did it just now, catalytic hydrogenation in the presence of nickel or platinum. For producing artificial petrol from coal, that is hydrogenation of coal. Next, use in extraction of metal. We also did just now that hydrogen reduces the heated metallic oxides to metal. And last but not the least, to study weather conditions in meteorological balloons. But helium is preferred as hydrogen is highly inflammable, so not safe to use. There are some questions which you should know and can be put in the question 100%. Addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen is what you should know. Loss of electron, gain of electron is what. Addition of electropositive atom or electronegative atom. And I will be doing about this redox, oxidation and reduction in detail. So in my next slide will be this. Where I'm talking about redox, that is oxidation and reduction reaction taking place either in the same equation or separately. But separately it is possible only for few of the reaction, but to understand the mechanism is very important, as I showed you just now. That loss of electrons is oxidation and gain of electrons is reduction. So zinc, when loses two electrons, it will give you zinc ion, that is formation of a cation, is oxidation. Copper ion, when it gains two electrons, gives you copper metal, so gain of electrons is reduction. Now this one is very easy. Addition of oxygen, you all know, is oxidation. Like carbon plus oxygen is giving you carbon dioxide. I've taken a very simple equation. Or removal of oxygen, like zinc oxide plus carbon is giving you zinc plus carbon monoxide, is reduction, because oxygen is removed from here. Removal of hydrogen is oxidation, that is H2S plus chlorine. So hydrogen is removed, sulfur is given out, HCl, so this is oxidized. At the same time, addition of hydrogen, that is ammonia and chlorine, will give you nitrogen and HCl. So hydrogen is added to chlorine and that is reduced. Addition of electronegative ion. So FeCl2, that is ferrous chloride, plus chlorine will give you ferric chloride. That means chlorine is added to ferrous chloride. Therefore, addition of electronegative ion is oxidation. At the same time, we can also remember removal of electronegative ion is reduction, like ferric chloride plus H2S is giving you ferrous chloride. So this is reduced because one chlorine less gives you HCl and sulfur. Removal of electropositive ion is oxidation. So, equation. Removal of electropositive. So, potassium iodide plus hydrogen peroxide gives you potassium hydroxide and iodine. So, K is removed. Iodine, that is oxidized. Addition of electropositive ion is reduction. That is, mercurous chloride and so tin chloride will give you mercuric chloride and tin chloride. So stannous and stannic. Addition of electropositive, that is mercuric, becomes reduction. There are many other reactions also given in your text. You are expected to learn all of them, as I always say, along with the definitions. But you should also see that whenever a reaction takes place, whether it's oxidation or reduction, it is always with the help of a particular compound. So if that compound is helping to oxidize, it is an oxidizing agent. If it is helping to reduce, it's a reducing agent. And the definitions are given in your text. Please go through the text. You are expected to learn them thoroughly. There are certain examples also mentioned in your text and you are expected to learn all of them. Some of the examples I have written it here, like solid oxidizing agents are manganese dioxide, red lead, potassium permanganate, potassium carbon dichromate, bleaching powder. A liquid oxidizing agent is hydrogen peroxide, conch, nitric acid, bromine, etc. Gaseous like oxygen, ozone, chlorine and so on. Similarly, the reducing agent also, some of the, like all the metals are reducing agents. So carbon, all the metals I have written, glucose, solid reducing agent, liquids like hydrogen peroxide, hydrogen iodide, hydrogen bromide. There are some gaseous also, H2S, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide. So if you see, sulfur dioxide can be treated as both oxidizing agent and reducing agent. And hydrogen peroxide also can be treated as both oxidizing agent and reducing agent. These are some of the names you should remember. And there are many more in your text. You are expected to learn all of them because in a question we can jumble all of them and ask you to segregate as oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Coming to the next slide. Here, how will you prove in a chemical reaction that one substance is oxidized and the other is reduced? That is, how will you prove that it is a redox reaction? So I have taken some examples here. So the first example that I have taken here is copper sulfate with zinc. And I just now said any metal is a reducing agent. With zinc gives you zinc sulfate and copper. If I break down into cation and anion, I get copper ion, sulfate ion plus zinc, no charge. Gives you zinc ion, sulfate ion and copper, no charge. So how is the conversion taking place? Zinc is becoming zinc ion, cation. So zinc becomes Zn2 plus only by losing two electrons, so it gets oxidized. Whereas copper ion becomes copper here and it is only possible when it accepts or gains two electrons, so it gets reduced. Therefore, we know which one is oxidized and which one is reduced through ionic equation. Now, if simply also an equation can be solved as copper oxide plus hydrogen gives you copper plus water. Now, copper oxide to copper and hydrogen to water. So, oxygen gets added. This is oxidized. Oxygen gets removed. So, it is reduction. So, oxidation, reduction. There's two more examples that I've taken. One is iron plus copper sulfate gives you ferrous sulfate plus copper. So Fe, no charge. Copper ion, sulfate ion gives you iron, ferrous charge, sulfate and copper no charge. So iron becomes Fe2 plus. How? By loss of electrons, so oxidation. Copper ion becomes copper by gain of electrons, so reduction, so it's a redox reaction. Now there is one more example that I've taken. H2S plus chlorine gives you HCl plus sulfur. So H2S, 2S, that means hydrogen, electropositive removed, so oxidized. Chlorine, hydrogen is added, so it is reduced. So these are some of the ways to prove how the reaction is redox reaction, which one is oxidized, which one is reduced. With proper reasoning you have to give. There are many examples also in the text exercise. You can go through all of them. Try out the equations, try out the reasoning questions. And if there are any doubt, children, please put in the comment section so that I can clear. Children, please hit the like button. Share and subscribe my channel. Do hit the bell icon to get notified of the upcoming video.